first time in 2 years that I haven't had summer school, so this is going to be a great opportunity for me to upload more videos to this channel more frequently. So I was also thinking of including other DIY projects other than sewing. I was thinking of doing more yarn-based projects with knitting and crocheting because I've been really into these two things lately. And if you have anything that you want me to do, just comment below and I will see if I can make it. For today's tutorial, we are going to make lined drawstring pouches like this. In the tutorial, it's going to be this size and lined inside, but if you don't like the size of this, I will also include measurements for the bigger lined pouch. Whoops! Boop. There you go. I cut out 3 pieces of fabric. The yellow is the lining and the other fabric is the outer layer. I placed the lining on top of the outer layer with the right size touching, and then I'm going to pin those 2 pieces onto the outer layer. Sew the edge along the tan line on the sewing machine. Snip snip, cut off the loose thread. Fold the fabric in half and you're going to align the 2 edges where the fabrics meet together. Make sure the flaps are folded in the same direction when you're pinning it. You're going to do this on the other side as well. Starting from the fold of the outer fabric, make 2 lines between 3 and 4 inches. This is where your gap for the string will be at the end of the project. Now mark a gap that is 1.5 inches wide somewhere in the middle of the lining of the fabric. Sew along the orange lines and make sure you backstitch wherever there is a gap. Flip the fabric inside out from the lining opening. Slip stitch the lining opening together. I'm not very good at slip stitching, and if you don't know how to slip stitch, I recommend watching other YouTube videos of how to do this skill. Now tuck the lining inside the outer fabric. Find the drawstring hole on the side and sew right under the hole all the way around. Pin the end of the ribbon with the safety pin and insert the safety pin into the hollow space in the pouch. Gently push the safety pin through the space until it reaches the beginning. The last step is to tie a knot at the end of the ribbon. Alright, and now you are done! I hope you enjoyed that tutorial, and if you liked what you see, give me a thumbs up, subscribe, and let me know in the comments below what you want to see next. Alright, see you next time, bye!